Greetings, everyone. Armando Fox here, and welcome to the advanced portion of the Agile Development Using Ruby on Rails course on edX, brought to you by UC Berkeley and with a lot of help from Agile Ventures. We assume if you took the part one of this course that you know what to expect. This is a fast-paced course that really tries to reflect modern software engineering practices used in the world's leading software companies. In part one of the course, the basics, you learn the basics of the BDD and TDD cycle, that's behavior-driven design, and test-driven development, with the Rails framework, the Ruby language, the RSpec tool for creating unit and functional tests, and the Cucumber tool for creating integration and acceptance level tests in the form of scenarios based on user stories. We'll develop those skills further in this part, but we'll focus on new mechanisms that will help you build more powerful applications. We'll talk about advanced features of the Rails framework, such as associations and how to support things like single sign-on. We'll talk about JavaScript and its role as the scripting language to make rich client-side apps and how that integrates with Rails, bringing the practices to bear in the JavaScript world that we've already seen in the Rails world, so practices about unit testing and coverage. In addition, we'll talk quite a bit about working with legacy code. Now, for some people, legacy code conjures up an image of some code that was written 40 or 50 years ago and is running on some computer in a basement somewhere. But in point of fact, legacy code is any code that you didn't really write yourself or that you haven't seen in a long time, even if you did write it yourself, but it's still in use because it meets a customer need. As it turns out, many of the techniques that we've learned for agile development can also be used in exploring, modifying, and enhancing legacy code. So that will be a major topic of the course as well. Part of the legacy code topic includes design patterns. These are patterns that over time have emerged as good structural solutions to particular programming problems. And as we discuss legacy code, we'll discuss what beautiful code means and how you can learn to identify opportunities both in your own new code and in legacy code to apply design patterns to make the code more beautiful and better structured and revealing of its intent. By the end of part two, this advanced Ruby on Rails course, you'll be in a position to participate in a real project team building an application for a real customer. In fact, many such opportunities for doing that, with mentoring and pairing with other developers around the world, are available through Agile Ventures. So with that, I'm going to welcome you again to the course, and I'm going to leave you in the capable hands of Professor Sam Joseph, who's also the founder of Agile Ventures, and will have some information about how you can participate in Agile Ventures projects armed with the experience you've learned in these courses. Thanks, and have a great course.